Good morning, dear student. Today we are going to discuss about developing research approach. Developing research approach, why research approach is required? Research approach is the way of dealing with a particular research problem. In research approach, we are considering about the logical path by which any person can reach to their goal, any researcher can reach to their goal, what type of the results he wants to reach to there. Types of the researches, research approaches: deductive research approach, inductive research approach, and abductive research approach. It should be clear here, deductive research approach should be based on theory, and inductive research approach should be based on observations. It should be very clear. Means deductive approach means a lot of theories are there. Theories have been formed, developed, and on that theory is based, we'll make the hypothesis and then we'll go for the test and rejection and acceptance till it depend. In inductive approach, it is just like first we'll observe the things, whatever the data and whatever the observations, and then we'll go for the observation, then we'll go for the pattern, and then we'll go for the make the theory if possible. In abductive approach, it is in between, by observation or by theory, both can be in between part, by observation and by theories, both will be helpful to this particular approach. So this is the three type of approaches. In detail we are going to study. Deductive approach. A deductive approach is concerned with the developing a hypothesis or hypotheses based on the existing theory and then designing a research strategy to test the hypothesis. Like impact of bonus on sales performance is banking industry. It is true, bonus, every person is like, every salesperson will like. So this is the true, and this is the theory, the characteristic theory. So then, if any person is approaching then we'll go for the test this. Before I then on basis of this theory will develop the hypothesis, he may be his performance may be increased, his performance may not be increased, but it will be based on observation test, then confirmation or rejection. The basic concept behind this theory, the general rules reach to a specific conclusion or by the help of theory. Okay, so this is deductive approach. Now next is inductive approach. Inductive approach, also known in the inductive inductive reasoning, starts with the observations and theories are proposed towards the end of the research process as a result of the observations. Here we will first maintain the observations based on the observation and test. Then we will go for the pattern. Then we will go for the theory. Maslow has first observed things. Then he has made the need hierarchy theory. He has observed about person have basic need, then person have security need, social need, esteem need, then go for the self-actualization. So he has observed, then he has make the such theory. So this is the pattern by which any researcher can make theory on the basis of their observations. The specific observations really become as a general conclusion. Means Porter's five factors models. Porter has given five factor model for the competition to any industry. And if any industry is influenced by this particular theory, we'll observe these things first. And we'll first observe the, he has observed these things, and then he has made the pattern, then this theory has begun. The, all the theories will be based on inductive approach, is observation, test, pattern and theory. This is the basic concept of this particular theory approach. Abductive approach, it is in between. Abductive approach is set to address weaknesses associated with the deductive and inductive approaches. What were the weaknesses? Specifically deductive research is criticized for the lack of clarity in the terms of how to select the theory to be tested via formulating hypothesis. And inductive reasoning, on the other hand, criticized because no amount of empirical data will necessarily enable the theory building. Mainly here it is very, very difficult to find out, in this approach it is very much difficult to find out which particular theory will be most applicable. Suppose we want to do a study to bank behavioral approach, buying behavior pattern or motivational theory of, which particular theory of motivation will be applicable in this particular situation, this particular research, how we will select, how a researcher will select, and what data he will collect, then it will be related with their research or not related. It is correlated with this, in that particular study, or not correlated. So this is the major things we are considering in inductive approach. Example, greed is the reasons behind any recession in economy. This is the example of this abductive approach. Abductive approach reasoning is incomplete observations, because number of observations, which observation may be suitable for that particular research, it is not possible. And best prediction, on the basis of these particular research or theories, a researcher will make number of options, will take number of options, and which will be best providing result, then he will select that particular theory and other concepts. Difference among the three approaches: abductive approach reasoning, incomplete observations, bad prediction, best prediction may be true, deductive reasoning, general rules, specific conclusion, always true, and specific observations, inductive reasoning, in specific observations, general conclusion may be true. So we should be careful about this logics, and then we will get right result. Examples of deductive approach: all eagles can fly. It is the theory. Tweety is eagle, therefore Tweety can fly. So it is on the basis of the results. Tweety is eagle, he has found out, any researcher has found out, and therefore Tweety can fly. Not every employee has a motivational label by salary. We know salary is a motivational part. It is not every person, it will be tested. And get such result. In e-business adoption does not have impact on sales performance. E-businesses does not have e-business is impacting to business and or sales, but in that particular stage not performing. So there should have logic behind that. Inductive approach, observation, all the code that I have seen ever were black. Inference, all the crows everywhere, including ones I have never seen, are black. Then, what observations toward an inference? Means this will be observation. This was the observation of any research. All the crows that he has seen was black. On the basis of that observation, he is concluding any other crow that will be black. This is the concept in inductive approach. Then next is abductive approach. Observation, the grass outside my window was wet when I woke up this morning. The grass outside my window was wet when I woke up this morning. Known fact, rain in the night can make grass wet. It may be possible, but it may not be possible. It may be possible someone has left their tap open. Maybe it may not be much possibility, but it probably it may be possible. So then possibilities are there. Abductive inference, there was probably rain in night. So then probably rain in night, maybe by rain it can be, but probably not. Thank you very much. We'll discuss next topic, types of research design, in next lecture.